Oh, hello.
Tony Slattery conducts the music game.
In his bleak and funereal oratorio, The Gates of Hell, Gustav Mahler wrote, "Within my house the slit-eyed angel of despair pukes betrayal over the rotting corpses of the innocent." And I thought to myself, you're a bit of a gloomy old sod. You should be watching the music game. And you know, I think he might well be. My first guest tonight, the staggeringly brilliant violinist who opened the show with that hot rendition of the Gigue from Bach's Partita in D minor. She's a principal violinist with the London Chamber Orchestra and has performed to massive audiences in the famous and controversial Power Proms. Her aim is to widen the appeal of classical music by making the whole thing a bit less poncy, but without removing all the nice twiddly bits. She is the fabulous Cathy Thompson! Next, a comedian, actor, and musician. He's a resident expert on the brain drain and recently co-starred in a bizarre stage show called Arthur Smith Sings Andy Williams. He's got a razor wit, a cheeky grin, and a swollen pancreas. Yes, he's the fabulous Tony Hawks! And finally, what can I say? This is a personal heroine of mine, and indeed, I can already feel myself beginning to froth. A legendary singer with an exquisite and utterly idiosyncratic voice. What more can be said, except that she is the one and only Sandie Shaw! And lastly, my resident factotum and children's entertainer, the man to whom the great Mrs. Mills once said, "Drop 'em, big boy." Yes, it's Dr. Richard Vranch! Welcome to you all. First, we start off with a round of general questions just to find out where your weak spots are. Here we go. Cathy, take a look at your monitor and see what happens if a ballerina misses just one day of practice. So, Cathy, could you name the ballet and the composer, please?
It's Coppelia.
Coppelia for 1 point. By...
Is it Delibes?
It is, yeah. Delibes for 2 points. Well done. Tony, take a look in your monitor at this little hymn to peace and harmony. Right, Tony. That was Sowing the Seeds of Love, Tears for Fears. Who was the female singer who sang backing vocals on the album Seeds of Love, who went on to have a major hit as a soloist?
Ah, yes, this was Alita Adams.
That's right.
And I think the record was called Get There If You Can.
That's right, yes.
But it had a very good lyric line in it. One of the lines was something like, I can windsurf into your life, or something like that.
That's right.
I'd just share that with you for no reason.
It's an excellent way of getting there. Well done. 2 points. Sandy, your general question. Listen to this, the Prime Minister's latest State of the Nation address.
Panic on the streets of London. Panic on the streets
recording... Oh, sorry, we
got... Sorry, I was just a little groove.
A little groove?
Very little.
All right, that's lovely. According to the Smiths, heaven knows Morrissey's what now?
Oh, incredibly happy. Miserable.
Miserable, that's right.
They're miserable old sod.
He's a miserable old sod.
So they say.
That was the original title. I'm a miserable old sod. That's right, the answer is miserable on that record. Right. Now, in this next round, you're going to hear some tapes that have been edited by the Attorney General. So obviously they won't make any sense at all. But I'm sure you'll be able to sort them out. Tony, you're going to hear two songs played simultaneously, and I want you to identify them.
Right, they're both Rolling Stones numbers, I reckon.
That's right.
Honky Tonk Women.
For 2 points.
Was it Jumping Jack Flash?
It was, for 2 points. Oh. Also, what was the title of the Bob and Earl hit that the Rolling Stones successfully revived in 1986?
Harlem Shuffle.
It was, so 6 full points. Well done. Sandy, you're going to hit... Hello?
Yes.
Sorry, you're yes. Kind of nodding off.
Yes.
Here we go, then. You're going to hear two tracks sandwiched together. Identify them.
What?
That's quite difficult. Could you distinguish either of those?
Absolutely not, no.
No? Okay. Well, in fact, something... One of them was...
Were they mine?
One was Phil Collins.
Oh, you... Oh, Cathy,
hello.
Fire.
What's that?
Was One Earth, Wind and Fire?
No, one wasn't
no.
Earth, Wind and Fire.
Phil Collins?
One was Phil Collins.
Oh, the Heaven thing.
All right, and you can have a bonus point for saying the Heaven. So, it's a very democratic round, this, ladies and gentlemen. And the other one was It's My Life. It's My Life by Talk Talk. Yeah. They used that for a tampon.
Of course.
Didn't they?
Yeah. How silly of me.
Apparently, when you use this tampon, you can be dragged across a beach by sheepdogs. I think that's kind of the ad, isn't it? I seem to remember.
Exactly.
That's right.
Why did you give it to me?
I don't know. because we thought you might know.
Yeah.
Talking of Phil Collins, which we weren't, we were talking of tampons, but close second. Talking of Phil Collins, which British group had a hit in 1966 with A Groovy Kind of Love?
Wayne Fontana and the Mindbenders.
Absolutely right, 2 points.
And Pet Clark.
And who?
Petula Clark.
Did she record it as well?
Mm.
Oh, right, we could have an extra point for that. Anyone else record
it? I recorded it as well.
No, you did not. No, you did not.
I sung it in the bath a few times.
Oh, well, that doesn't qualify you to get any points.
Oh.
Which was, in fact, a rather boring thing for me to say. So I thought I'd share it with you. Right, Cathy, you're going to hear two songs played simultaneously, and I want you to identify them.
That's
Cathy.
Easy, because I know that. It's the Beatles.
Pardon me for breathing, ladies
sorry.
And gentlemen. Apparently it was too easy.
Ticket to Ride.
Ticket to Ride.
And, Can't Buy Me Love.
All right. 4 easy points, ladies and gentlemen. And Strawberry Fields Forever, Cathy, was one half of a Beatles double A-side hit. What was the other song?
Oh, guessing. Yesterday?
It wasn't. Bonus point, anyone? Double A-side. Strawberry Fields and...
I think you should give us a little clue.
Oh, it was a straight song, wasn't it? It was the,
yes.
Was it the one that George Harrison wrote? Something.
No.
It was,
All right.
Nearly there?
No.
No, it was Penny Lane.
Of course.
No.
It was Penny Lane.
I was there.
Yes.
No, clearly it wasn't. Sorry, Tony. Okay.
Well, no points for that, because that's on my card anyway. Right, now it's time to play Name That Snatch. Richard, over to you.
Thank you, Tony. Now, I'm going to play each of you a short snatch of music. And I'd like you to tell me what it is. And there is a connection between them. So the first one is for Cathy. What's that one? It's a tricky one.
Can I ask, is it classical? I mean,
it's kind of in between these. It kind of crosses over between classical and
it sounds
pop.
Very film music-y, sort of.
No.
It's not film. Is it not Copeland?
Not Copeland?
No, I don't know, sorry.
Well, I have to tell you, in fact, it was by the Penguin Cafe Orchestra. Yes, Simon Jeffs, and it was called Perpetual Mobile. Okay, never mind. Sandie, this one's for you. This was from a very big film, and it was at number one for ages.
Oh, how could I possibly... I did it for you.
You're quite right. Everything I do, brackets, I do it for you by Brian Adams. 2 points.
That as well.
Very good. Tony, this one's yours.
Why do I have such a down market one?
Do you know it?
Well, that's Messing About on the River, isn't it? Messing
about. No.
Oh, well, it's that other guy, the whistling bloke, yes, had a hit with it. Whistling Jack Douglas or someone.
Yeah.
Whistling,
I'll give
Jack.
Whistling Jack Smith. Do you know the title of the song?
Messing About on the River. No, I don't know.
I'll give you 1 point. The title was I Was Kaiser Bill's Batman.
Oh,
right,
close.
Okay, so fingers on buzzers for the bonus 2 points. Can you think of a connection between Everything I Do from the film Robin Hood, I Was Kaiser Bill's Batman, and the Penguin Cafe Orchestra? Tony!
I think the connection is Batman film. You've got your character Penguin, and you've got Robin, of course, who lives alongside him and sort of runs around in a cape.
That was an excellent answer, Tony. 2 points. 2 points.
Well done. Excellent. Well done. Good. Right, everyone, listen to this, please. I want you to imagine that you're trapped in a lift in the lower basement level of eternal damnation. A fab song is playing on the tannoy. Tragically, the song is sung like this.
Hey there, Georgie girl, swinging down the street so fancy free. Nobody you meet could ever see the loneliness there inside you. Hey there, Georgie girl, why do all the boys just pass you by? Could it be you just don't try?
Now, fingers on buzzers, 2 points. Name that singer. Have a stab.
I know him, I know his face and everything.
He's an actor, isn't he?
Yes, and he was in all carry-on films, wasn't
That's
he?
Right.
Oh, bugger, you pinched my... How can you say that?
I'm prepared
You're
to...
You're so competitive.
I'll hand it over to you because I quite like the use of my
Jim
other
Dale.
Arm.
Jim Dale!
Jim Dale, I'm going to have to give it to Sandie. 2 points for
Sorry,
Sandie.
Sorry, I think...
I'd just like to say that these buzzer systems are redundant if you can just break someone's arm and then get the arm.
Excellent. Oh, Sandy's having a turn. Right,
sorry.
At this halfway stage, we see that the scores are still pretty close. In third place with 6 is Cathy. In second place, but only just with 10, is Sandie. But in the lead at this halfway stage with 11 points is Tony! Well, my underwear's beginning to cut a bit, so I'm going to have to get in there and have a good rummage. So, why don't you just take a short break? See you in a minute. Close your eyes.